Is the tree made by the Hannahs with the help of the Condens.
Okay.
Here's the woman who did all this. Hello, woman who did all this. How are you?
After the Christmas party. That's what we did.
First of all, we need to know that it's a place to put... Oh, that's a real drippy one. You may use it, but it needs to sit in a bowl. A candle. Do you know how it rolls around? We have to put that in a bowl. One of the smaller bowls, maybe?
No, the ones Becky's using.
Becky's using bowls?
Yeah, Becky's using a bowl.
What's in your hand?
Because you made it, so tell me what it means.
This is the earth. This is shepherds. I don't know what, something about the shepherds. These are the gifts that God gave us, the little candies, and this is us.
Why is that us?
I thought the light represented Jesus.
Yep.
And the red ribbon?
That's how you get in trouble. Oh, can you pull out the other one quick? It's about to. Oh, careful.
See, you got an orange, then you got a knife, and you picked out some of the orange, then you put a candle in, then you got a toothpick, and there was lots of bags of candy and raisins and marshmallows and stuff. So you put them on the toothpick, and then you stick them.
Colin, hold still.
Orange. And then you tied a ribbon around it and you kind of like...
Did you even tie the ribbon?
Yeah. No, you don't tie it, see? Oh, yeah.
How many did you make?
52.
52? Where did you make?
At the church. St. John Cathedral.
Hello, Zoe. What do you think of Christmas? Any comments for the reporters here?
Yeah, what did I tell you?
Any comments, Zoe?
No,
Meister. Not much comment from Zoe. You have any comments for Zoe, Colin?
Yeah, she's the most beautiful cat in the whole wide world, and she's enjoying this Christmas. Yeah, but... Oh, come on! Oh, you're not there!
How do you know that's yours?
Bye,
I'm
Zoe.
Being you're just...
Ooh.
Yeah, you're just... Oh,
I thought you didn't answer your
question. Dad! I'm gonna aim for the video camera.
Then you gotta go back and do it again. I didn't get it on film. Actually, there's not enough lights.
Let me try
it
then. Can I do it, Mom?
Yep.
Oh, stop.
Get down below. What is it, LVs or L's with attitude?
L's with attitude. It's in the Santa Claus.
What's the Santa Claus?
It's a movie that we watch at the continents.
Oh.
Why? Oh, I missed the bad guy that time.
Becky says she has one. There's one in the wrapping stuff. It's like in the little card bag. And Becky said she had more tape.
They flew with sleigh full of toys and Saint Nicholas too. And then in a twinkling, I heard on the roof the prancing and pawing of each little hoof. As I drew in my head and turning around down the chimney, Saint Nicholas came into a bound. Okay. The tiny miniature.
Miniature sleigh and 8 tiny reindeer.
Miniature sleigh and 8 tiny reindeer. Down the chimney.
Mom,
Saint Nicholas came.
Doesn't have red and white and red and green. Well, it doesn't have red and white. He is colorful.
Now there's Santa
working in his house. to make all the beautiful things. And then,
Colin, sit down.
His cheeks were like roses, his nose like a cherry. His jaw like a mouth was drawn up like a bow, and the beard on his chin was as white as the snow. The stump of a pipe he held tight in his teeth, and the smoke in it encircled his head like a wreath. He had a broad face and
said,
it says, Colin?
And he whistled and chatted and called him by name. Now Dasher, now Dancer, now Prancer, and Vixen, I'm Comet, I'm Cupid, I'm Dunder and Blitzen. Woo! I read like the picture ones, okay?
Okay.
His opening his pack, his eyes, his... Which one do you want this one?
I know, but these are the pictures.
Oh. His eyes, how they twinkled, his dimples, how merry.
Picture.
He was chubby and plump, a right jolly old elf, and I laughed when I saw him. In spite of myself, a wink of his eye and a twist of his head soon gave her. He drove out of sight. Merry Christmas to all, and all a good night.
At the last day of school.
What? Can I go? One day, Petey, who was a puppy, said to his mother, "I like a boy for Christmas." His mother, who was a dog, said she guessed he could have a boy if he was a very good puppy. So the day before Christmas, Petey's mother asked, "Have you been a very good pup?" "Oh, yes," said Petey. "I guess you've been good." And his mother, "Anyway, you're awfully little. I shall go out and get you a boy for Christmas." But when Petey's mother came back, she looked very much worried. "How would you like a soft white rabbit with pink ears for Christmas?" she said to Petey. "No, thanks," said Petey. "Don't you want a lovely canary?" No, I just wanted a boy. I just wanted a boy, yeah. "How about some guppy fish?" "They're nice," said Petey's mother. "I don't like fish," said Petey. "I like a boy." Petey said his mother, "There are no boys to be had." "No boys," exclaimed Petey in dismay. "Not one could I find. We're terribly short of boys this year." Petey felt as if he couldn't stand it if he didn't have a boy. Finally, his mother said, "There now, there must be a boy somewhere. Perhaps you could find some dog who would be glad to give his boy away." So Petey hopefully started off. It wasn't long before he saw a collie racing with a boy on a bicycle. Petey trembled with joy. He called out to the collie, "Excuse me, do you want to give all as much?" Soon Petey came to a bulldog sitting in a car with a boy. Petey was pleased, for he was getting tired from so much walking, so he called out loud, but very politely, "Excuse me, do you want to give your boy away?" But the bulldog said, "No!" He definitely didn't. He growled in Petey's face. "Oh dear," said Petey. "Oh dear," said Petey. He ran off behind the house and stayed there until the bulldog and his boy drove away. "Well, who wants to go riding in a car?" "Poof, not me," said Petey. Oh, got the same picture. After a while, he met a Scotty, walking with his boy and carrying a package in his mouth. "Now, that is a goody," he must say. Petey wriggled away from the hands that petted him. Dickie was the one he loved best. "But whoever would think," said Petey to himself, "that I'd get 50 boys for Christmas." Dun, dun, dun. Thank you. No autograph. Thank you.
That was terrific. I didn't know that story.
That's it for me. Maybe we don't listen to what did you say, Mom?
Okay. I didn't know that story before, so I really enjoyed it. Everybody got 50 boys.
The snow specks.
Speeds.
That's what I thought it was, but then.
The snow speeds.
At first, white snow flaked.
blow softly to earth, and children's faces fill the window with longing. The snow speaks out a greeting, hello, 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 as if it just came to visit. But the children know it is here to stay. Or like this.
No, that's too high.
When words freeze in the thin, brittle air, and nostrils stick. I can't read like that. Stick together. The snow speaks. It squeaks and crunches under the children's feet. Cold, cold, cold. The children know this stubborn snow will not be held within a snowman's shape. It is
a Lego technique, Mom! I got Lego technique racing car! Yes!
Mom. Oh yeah, what? This is amazing. I think you got the exact one, or someone got, Richie Rich got the exact one that I was.
Who gave Rich, that to you?
Richie Rich.
Richie Rich gave you a wallet?
Yeah, amazing, huh? And the mom says I couldn't give you something. The mom has a goosebump calendar. I like this one. Put them both up. Yeah. Look at that. Don't take it out. Hello, Dad. I got a new wallet.
Let me see the wallet. Let me see.
I was looking at them with my friend. Ooh. And I spent like money.
Oh, wow.
Hi, Richie Rich. No, which one you want?
Here we are with new Christmas toys. Becky, first time learning to roller skate.
Stop! I'm gonna bring it over there.
He can bring it over.
Drive it over there.
Let's see you skate, Beckaroos.
What?
Let's see you skate.
My swing?
Skate. There you go.
I just learned, so I'm not that great.
Okay, go for it. Go, got Colin coming. Skate, Colin.
And for the opening finish!
Keep going. Go back. Yeah, I did. Pick your feet up a little more. You got it.
Oh, it's hard taking over you. Because I was just behind her by a lot, and then suddenly I went.
Uh oh, we got a big one. And here's the elephant we're gonna get on, I guess. There's her pulling away. Hey guys.
Hey.
We got Becky getting on.
Yeah.
As you can see, this picture is wiggling because the elephant is wiggling. And here's the scenery. This is the Pei River. And we're running out of tape, so I'll put in a new tape. So here we are. We're actually not January 1st, it's January 2nd, but so don't worry about that date. There's long tail boats going down the river.
We've got the baby elephant because you've got the mama.
Yeah, we do. This river borders along the... goes along the Thai River, along the border with Burma. So, before there was tourism, the big thing to do around here was to smuggle.
She just had her back.
Trying to climb up the ridge here. I think we can't see anything. There we go. She just had her bath.
What?
She's floating in the water. It's really cute.
On her elephant.
You just cracked
there's
a
the
shell.
Baby elephant trying to track a shell.
And I'm eating it.
And then up here we've got Diana and Colin.
We passed them.
And we... Yeah, she went fast downhill, didn't she?
Yeah, because he's small. You can just go whew, just like that. Why not me? Me?
Oh, no.
Of course, he has to have a little fun time.
Lunch chocolate.
Here's the elephant in the river, deciding it's a good time to eat.
Hey there.
Hey guys.
Giant.
Yeah.
There.
There we are.
Do you think they wash the elephants?
Mm-hmm. No, the elephants get bathed this bed this way. It's the river. More young elephants. And our driver.
I'm gonna get what I'm gonna be.
Oh God, I've been recording this whole time.
What?
Oh, I've been recording pictures of my pants.
Of your what?
Of my pants. See, there they are. See the elephant's trunk? Mm. Trying to figure out what to do.
Yeah, my boy.
He has to curl his little finger around. Yeah, my boy. Okay, just curling around. That's all he's doing. That's how he has to do. Well, down here, one. Not look by some.
Why don't you go give one to the dad over there?
No, that's the mom.
The mom?
That's the mom. It looks like a banana.
Yeah, you can put it in the bushes. Yeah. Yeah. He thought the camera was the banana.
And it's about the same size.
Okay. And here we have the suspension bridge being used by people trying to get to Burma quick. This is a shortcut bridge. So this is going down the river.
Which one do you like better? Being by myself, you being by yourself. Mommy could always make up with me.
We're just on a bamboo raft floating down the Bay River. The farmhouse along the ridge, and you can see the different fruit trees.
This one only along the Burmese forest. And in Chan State, yeah, they speak the same. In
so
Burma. And then in Kellet State, like down south. Like in Thailand,
in
Burma.
Let me tell you,
Now move your arm!
Now move your arm around the way! Two. Now nod your head.
One,
two, two.
I feel so stupid.
Now wiggle your butt.
One, two,
two, two, two. Now be intelligent.
So where is this aerobic show coming from?
Oh, I am a whip. I am so good at aerobics. I am a whip. No, I am not a whip.
Coming in the landing, dog. Be prepared to
very close up for landing.
Two, 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 one, two.
Okay, here we are.
Aerobic Mae Hong Song.
See how your muscles form? Like me.
Your muscles form. See, this is how when people were not on aerobics and stuff.
Oh dear. Oh,
now this is when they were. Now this is when they are on aerobics and stuff.
Okay, we are here at Mae Hong Song Advertising Center. Take one.
Cut! I'm gonna push my sister in with my really cool new magic set. One, two, three. Magic! Get your new awesome magic set and your free brochure! And you can push your friend and family far away. Get your new awesome magic set and a free brochure. Call 222 for inside information on your new magic set!
What do you think, Director Dodd?
I think we should move on to the awesome, magical, mystery, 2-2-2
treasure
hunt.
Daddy's been very busy making up a treasure hunt here in Bay Hong Kong. This is a cute little
towel.
Place for this game.
I need a towel!
Sorry, we didn't have any towels. You had to ask E, because we left him at the restaurant last night. Right, you're in Thailand. Are you cold in Thailand?
Yeah.
Thank you. Thank you. I'm not sure.
Around about, more or less, children here. It was their first day in the reception class at Kellet. For others, the major event took place at schools around the world. I'm sure that both the children and parents here tonight remember those very, very early days. This week I went down to reception. I couldn't believe that the reception children that we have now were those very, very tiny, insecure, not quite sure where they were going children last September. You were like that once. When we look at these mature, caring, thoughtful children that we've got here tonight, it's hard to believe. In September 1996, you came together as two classes, very much as you are now. In November, I had the pleasure of joining you at Camp Orlando. I'm sure you'll remember those incredibly long walks. This is why I have to wear high heels now, because I tend to be shorter than before I went. And on return, you produced those wonderful topic books. Last term, you negotiated, planned, compromised, argued, discussed all the arrangements for your survival camp. And you went charting, and you did survive, and you came back intact. Although, when I read some of your first aid manuals, I wondered. Critical bleeding, compound fractures. If I'd read them before they left, I would never have let them out. My mistakes, you got very busy up to your final year. Personally, we know you as very individual children. And you will know inside of you all the very special achievements that you've made this year personally. Treasure those. They're special to us and they're special to you. Mastering those skills that perhaps have eluded you all through school. Learning to speak English fluently in less than a year. Taking a leading role in assembly or production, and I can go on and on and on. You have done so much and achieved so much. Primary 6, tonight, all of us here celebrate with you your completion of primary education. Next term, you'll be starting schools in Britain, United States, Australia, and Sweden. And thankfully, some of you will be studying in Hong Kong, so we'll still see your faces. But for those of you who are leaving, we're looking forward to hearing about how you settle in and get on in those early days. And it's not surprising if you feel a little anxious. It's the most natural thing in the world. But we know, your teachers and your mums and dads, that every single one of you is ready to move on. We would like to keep you. But there comes a time when there's new challenges, exciting adventures ahead, and you have to go for them. And that time has come. And we all look forward in years to come, hearing of your successes, as we do regularly of Kellet children who have left us. Primary 6, you are class of 1997. You are terrific. We are proud. I think everyone here this evening feels privileged to be part of the celebration of your passing on from primary school. Ladies and gentlemen, if you don't have glass in your hand, I would ask you to stand anyway. If you do have a glass, the toast is, please stand, the class of 97 and their future success. The class of 97
and their future success.
Thank you.
Thank you.
poop pouch. Time to go.
Yesterday. Dana's in lane 6 with the gold cap. We're this to the right of the Gat man standing up.
Right now. catch up, huh? Zoom in on the board?
Yeah, zoom on the board, thank you.
I don't know how to zoom. How do you zoom?
Oh, I don't know. Oh, it's okay.
Diana, are you a little excited?
There you go, perfect.
I wasn't videotaping.
Did anybody get the winning time in the 30?
29.
Okay, excellent.
I love that.
The dragon tried to trail them. Now,
One day, the daughter of the old pig got old too. And she told the three little pigs, "Now, I am getting old. You must go out into the world and venture for your fortune." So they all went to America. Now, the first pig, Pinky Pig, was walking along. Okay, now, the Pinky Pig was not very dumb pig, so he was walking along and she was gonna buy some food for her house.
"Hello, Mr. Puss. Can I please borrow some straw for my house?"
"Hey, don't think that's a very good idea."
"I'm sorry, could I please have some straw for my house?"
"It's going to cost you some money."
"Okay, here you go."
Tried to build a house out of straw, or the pig that tried to build a house out of sticks, would ya?
Definitely not. I'm a successful billionaire in Hong Kong.
Well, if building houses out of sticks and straw is no good, but building them out of bricks is a pretty good idea.
What about 9 million for bricks?
9 million bricks? What do you want, $9 million?
$9 million for some bricks.
Sure!
Okay, it's a deal. Thank you very much. Oh, isn't this house such a beauty and strong as well?
to this day, if people see green comets flying everywhere, they think that is it the rapping dragon that loves to rap. He is the green dragon, and beware, do not go too close, or he will try to huff you down.
Hello.
Hey, babe.
What?
Where are we?
We are in Sai Kung.
Pak Chau.
Sai Kung Country Park.
Well, so where are we? We're Pak Chau.
Sai Kung. Pak Chau. Sai Kung Country Park. In Hong Kong. In Asia. In the world.
Field.
In the universe. No, in the galaxy. In the universe. And so on. That's where we are, Mr. Camera. Bye-bye.
This is how we get in and out.
Sweet home Alabama.
Pose for a little guy. That was Colin's race last year.
I would
yep. What's his name over there? Nate's there. Oh, I think it is.
Hey, heat, the fastest heat. Some 109s and 110s in this heat. Haley next to her is a butterfly. Right next to her is Haley DeGolia, her old butterfly friend. Okay, gotta catch up to Haley. Renee's made count at the last meet. Come on, Becky. A little bit tired from Bear, because.
Hey!
Go, Becky!
Let's go, Becky! 28! 28! 28!
Let's go, Becky! Oh, maybe we got more than one Becky here.
Take your mark.
Those flags are in the way.
Go, Becky!
Okay, she had 29.8 the other night. The boys that his fast time is 1:19. They'll kind of check him out. Waiting for this race at the Walnut Creek City meet for the 100 IM. Waiting at the ready bench. Okay, Don, this is for you. put a new meet record.
Good.
All right.
$3 for the breaststroke. Sitting down. About 105 out, so they have a screen over the kids, and this water mist is coming down, and the boys sit in these chairs for their heats, waiting for their turn to go. There's all the 7-8 girls. They gotta get up and hold hands, that's what Colin hates. The biggest reason is to start being 9 and 10, so you don't have to hold hands anymore as you go.
Court place far from where you're staying?
No.
No, they're just right around the corner.
Later.
All right, have fun.
Colin in his relay. We'll get back to that soon. kids all check out what they're going to swim on the thing. There's Coach Tony. Hi, Coach Tony. He's our man.
Yeah.
Go around desk area. Okay, this is the medley relay, so in a minute Colin will be swimming the butterfly. We'll get a picture of him. He'll be the butterfly leg. He's on the block. She'll be doing the freestyle in her medley relay. That's Renee just finished, and now Rachel's in the water. Notice how far Rachel goes. This is Rachel Whitehead. Becky will be the butterfly. We'll come back to that. Becky's up on the block, getting ready. Becky there. She'll be doing freestyle.
Well, looks like we got a sweep down here. Let's go. Let's
this is Ryan here. Okay, Colin. What are you going for tonight in the IM?
138.
What time?
138.
I got a 005.
118! Gosh! I hate you, you gamers!
Off he goes.
Give me my stuff. We got first place. We got first place.
Here. Best time is better than the pool record.
You might want to check the name of the swimmer in lane 6. Recorders, again, as a reminder, please confirm the name and the event. The name of the swimmer in your lane and the event is just for you. Swimmer, step up. Gentlemen, 100 yards,
more wrestling. This boy needs some more competition. Just to give you an idea how far in front he is. He's more than 3/4 of a full head. Not off quite as fast, but I must say he looked like he was kind of loafing it. Dana's got a big race here. Catherine Scropetta, always, they're both 9 years old, because always are racing. It's Becky up. Next up, Colin doing the breaststroke. 1890 is his best time. The IM, he did get a cool record. It's a rather disappointing time. Go, Cole!
25 yards, 30 yards. Take camera. Those off to the swimmers around the block, please, because they don't pay attention to the turn. Okay, gentlemen, 25 yards, breaststroke. Take your mark.
Your freestyle time was kind of off.
Me
too. You're a little bit tired.
From Rancho, Colorado.
Renee's up in lane three for San Miguel.
Ryan in front, Renee in the hat.
Wait!
Miguel, Colin, Hannah.
Go, Colin!
Congratulations.
Colin.
Travis, so fast and yet we're so bashful up here.
Kyle, let's see.
Okay, from West Trumpets, Aaron Dodd. Girls, 15-18, freestyle, sorry.